Hello, boa noite. Eu sou a Eli Sato. Seja muito bem-vindo em mais uma aula pro IELTS. Muito obrigada por você estar aqui. Eu fico muito feliz. Gente, hoje a gente vai ver uma super aula de listening. Eu vou colocar o exercício na tela para vocês. Vou rodar o áudio. Vocês anotem as respostas e aí a gente vai checar junto onde estava cada uma das respostas. Combinado? Então vamos lá, ó. A gente começa numa section 2. Só um minutinho. Bom, vamos lá. Primeiro, esse primeiro exercício, a gente vai fazer um label, né? Um label, um map. Então, label the plan of the Rock Festival site below. E aí a gente vai escolher sete de várias respostas. São três, seis, nove, sete de nove respostas possíveis para label esse mapa aí do Rock Festival, tá bom? Então tá aí na tela para vocês. Questions 11 to 17. Label the plan of the Rock Festival site below. Choose seven answers from the box and write the correct letter A to I. Next to questions 11 to 17, certo? Desculpa, eu falei que estava ótimo assim, mas tem como aumentar um pouquinho, deixar só o mapa e tirar o enunciado do exercício? É possível? Não? Não, deixa. Vamos lá. Vou rodar o áudio para vocês. Vocês anotem de 11 a 17. Quais são as respostas corretas, ok? Então vamos lá, prontos?
Section 3. You will hear. Section 4. You. Section 3.
Calma que a gente já acha a section certa. Yay!
You will hear the organizer of a rock festival talking to the exhibitors and performers at a planning meeting. First, you have some time to look at questions 11 to 17 on page 3.
Então, gente, vocês vão olhar para esse mapa, nesse tempinho que eles dão, e já tentar identificar onde está o quê, né? Tem a Main Gate, que está escrito ali, tem a Information Point, que está escrito ali, o 11 está bem do ladinho do Main Gate, depois lá na frente tem o 12 e o 13 que a gente precisa completar. Um espaço grande ali, o 14 é praticamente uma entrada ou uma saída, 15 também é uma entrada ou uma saída, 16 do lado das árvores e 17 ali no cantinho direito, do lado direito do Main Gate
Now
também.
listen carefully and answer questions 11 to 17.
Good evening, everyone. I'm glad you could all make this planning meeting for what promises to be the biggest and most colorful free rock festival ever held in the Southeast. So whether you're a performer, a craft exhibitor, or an artist, we all extend a big welcome to you. Could we turn first to the plan so I can familiarize you with the layout of the site, which, as you know, is an old football stadium. We're really lucky to have so much space this year. You can see the main gate at the bottom of the plan. Found it. That's where most visitors will enter. It's also the entrance for those taking part in the craft fair. We've set the stalls just inside the gate on the left in a circle. If you walk straight ahead from the gate along the path without turning right, you'll come to some steps up to the football stadium. On the left of the steps is the fringe stage. This is for alternative artists. They include folk singers, poets, and other acts which are more suited to a smaller stage. And they should also enter by the main gate. On the opposite side of the steps is a restaurant, and adjoining that is the main festival information point. Here you can get extra programs and up-to-the-minute information about events, and you can discuss any last-minute problems, although we hope everything will be running smoothly when the festival opens. Right. Coming back to the plan, you go up the stairs to the stadium. The entrance for the rock bands is on the far side, and on your right is the main stage, which will have powerful illumination and amplification throughout the weekend. There will probably be TV vehicles adjacent, that's in this area only for recording purposes. If you look at the outside of the plan, you can see a third gate for exhibitors opening onto a side path. A little way down the path, before you get to the trees, is the building where the art exhibition's being housed. Then, finally, there's just one more building marked on your plan, quite near the main gate. It's divided into lock-up garages, so I hope you now feel quite familiar with the main festival area.
Ok, deu para pegar tudo? Vamos checar, então? Então, vamos lá, gente. É, ele fala ali do main gate, né, ali embaixo, no meio. E aí, gente, enquanto você deu uma olhada no que você precisa pegar de informação, e enquanto isso, é, você dá uma olhada nas opções ali no box, ok? Então, ele começa falando, we're really lucky to have so much space this year. You can see the main gate at the bottom of the plan. Have you found it? That's where most visitors will enter. It's also the entrance for those taking part in the craft fair. Craft fair, okay? We set the stalls just inside the gate on the left in a circle. Então, gente, o número 11, que tá on the left of the main gate on a circle, é a craft fair, certo? Continuando, if you walk straight ahead from the gate along the path without turning right, you come to some steps up to the football stadium. On the left of the steps is the fringe stage. Número 12, fringe stage. Okay? This is for alternative artists. They include folk singers, poets, and other acts which are more suited to a smaller stage, and they should also enter by the main gate. On the opposite side of the steps is a restaurant. Então, número 13, restaurant. And adjoining that is the main festival information point. Here you can get extra programs and up-to-the-minute information about events, and you can discuss any last-minute problems, although we hope everything will be running smoothly when the festival opens. Continuando, right, coming back to the plan, you go up the stairs to the stadium. The entrance for the rock bands is on the far side. Okay, and on your right is the main stage, which will have powerful illumination amplification throughout the weekend. Então, número 14 ali, gente, é band entrance, ok? Que ele fala, the entrance for the rock bands is on the far side, ok? Continuando, if you look at the outside of the plan, you can see a third gate for exhibitors opening onto a side path. Então, número 15 é exhibitors entrance, letra E, exhibitors entrance. A little way down the path before you get to the trees is the building where the art exhibition's being housed. Então, número 16, art exhibition. Certo? Then finally, there's just one more building marked on your plan, quite near the main gate. It's divided into lock-up garages. Lock-up garage, letra G, lock-up garage, ok? Done? Gente, é uma dica importante, quando é um mapa assim, para você label as partes, tem que ficar muito atento, porque se você perde, muito atento, porque se você perde um turn left, um, né, look up from the map, there's another entrance, enfim, se você perde uma direção, você não consegue responder as outras perguntas. Então, tem que ficar muito atento com keywords, né? E não ficar tentando não voltar, tá bom? Continua com o áudio até o final do áudio, certo? Vamos continuar? Vou colocar outro exercício para vocês, ainda do mesmo áudio, ok? Então, são as questions 18 to 20. Complete the sentences below. Write no more than 2. Circulem gigantescamente na prova de vocês. Sempre que tivesse no more than 1, 2, 3 words, para vocês não errarem, tá? Às vezes vocês estão tão focados no listening ou no reading, encontrar a resposta, que a gente acaba perdendo a atenção para o número de palavras. E se você escrever mais que 2 words, você perde a questão, mesmo que esteja correto, ok? Então, no more than 2 words for each answer, certo? Vamos ouvir?
Before you hear the rest of the talk, you have some time to look at questions 18 to 20 on page 4.
Marcando as keywords, gente. You have to wear, official visitor, wear, 19. Cars blocking path could prevent access by, in an emergency, to reclaim
now
items from the storage.
Questions 18 to 20.
Vamos ouvir.
We also hope that you'll have received your welcome pack. In it, you should find 2 parking tickets for yourself and anyone assisting you, an armband to indicate that you are an official visitor, one of our brilliant yellow badges with the new festival logo, a festival program, and several sheets of information that we'd ask you to study carefully before the event. Please could you note that all setting up of stalls, displays, and so on should be completed by 9:30 a.m. and that, unfortunately, we won't be able to allow any vehicles to enter the festival area after that time. Yeah, it's a big site, but even a few vehicles parked in the wrong place can block the paths. With crowds of people, and we are expecting several thousand, this can merely be a nuisance. But if there's an emergency and access for an ambulance is blocked, the situation will become not just annoying, but also dangerous. Don't forget, it could be your mother or your child who needs help. Several exhibitors and craftspeople have asked us if any provision can be made for overnight storage of tables, chairs, and display items, rather than having to take them home and bring them again. We're pleased to say that a limited amount of space has been made available in the building near the main gate. You'll be issued with a yellow ticket to reclaim your property, similar to the red parking tickets. So do check you bring the right one. But please understand that this is entirely at your own risk, as we can take no responsibility for items lost or damaged. I think that's all I have to say at this point, but thank you all for your attention.
Ok. Deu para pegar os 3? Então vamos lá, gente. Número 18. To show you are an official visitor, you have to wear the... Ele fala, we also hope that you have received your welcome pack. In it, you should find 2 parking tickets for yourself and anyone assisting you. An armband to indicate that you are an official visitor. An armband, ok? So, número 18, to show you are an official visitor, you have to wear the armband provided, ok? Número 19, cars blocking path could prevent access by in an emergency. Vamos lá, ele fala, please could you note that all setting up of stalls, displays and so on should be completed by 9:30 a.m. and that, unfortunately, we won't be able to allow any vehicles to enter the festival area after that time. Yes, it's a big site, but even a few vehicles parked in the wrong place can block the path. With crowds of people, and we are expecting several thousand, These can merely be a nuisance, but if there's an emergency and access for an ambulance is blocked, the situation will become not just annoying, but also dangerous. Então, tudo isso para falar da ambulance. Ok? Ambulance. E, por fim, a número 20. To reclaim items from storage, you must show your... O quê? Vamos lá ver. Ele falou... several exhibitors and craft people have asked us if any provision can be made for overnight storage of tables, chairs, and displays items rather than having to take them home and bring them again. We are pleased to say that a limited amount of space has been made available in the building near the main gate. You will be issued with a yellow ticket to reclaim your property. Okay? You'll be issued with a yellow ticket to reclaim your property. Certo? Então, número 20, yellow ticket. Okay? Vamos para o próximo? Então, vamos mais um, gente. A prova de listening são 3 sessões. 4 sessões, desculpa. São 4 sessões, leva meia hora. Pode pôr a tela 3. Leva meia hora e você tem 10 minutos depois que acaba o áudio para passar suas respostas para a folha de respostas, tá bom? Então, nesse momento que você está vendo as questões e respondendo e ouvindo os áudios, não se preocupe com folha de resposta, você vai ter 10 minutos para isso e é mais do que suficiente para passar suas respostas para a folha de resposta. Então, não é o momento, ok? Faça as 4 sessões para depois entrar no para depois passar tudo para a folha de resposta, ok? Uma coisa importante, eu estou deixando para a gente fazer naquele tempinho que ele dá, mas para explicar não é tão rápido assim. Até lá vocês vão estar treinados para isso. Nesse tempinho que eles dão, desde o momento que você abre a prova, no tempinho que tem antes de começar o áudio, você vai olhar a questão e vai marcar as keywords rapidamente, tá? É muito mais rápido que no reading. Mas você vai marcar as keywords para que você, quando começar a tocar o áudio, você saiba que tipo de informação você precisa captar naquele áudio, ok? Então, olhando aí para essa questão, section 3, questions 21 to 30, questions 21 to 30, choose three letters from A to G. Which 3 factors does Marcos Tutor advise him to consider when selecting a course? Ok? Então a gente vai ouvir uma conversa e vocês precisam identificar quais 3 fatores desses todos aí são o tutor, né? O professor, o guia, mestre, enfim, do Marco advise him to consider when selecting a course. E aí você vai passar o olho sobre as possibilidades, tá? Então, possibility of specialization, relevance to future career, personal interest, organization of course, assessment methods, range of topics, reputation of lecturer. Certo? Então vamos lá?
Section 3. You will hear a discussion between a business student called Marco and his personal tutor about the courses that Marco should take. First, you have some time to look at questions 21 to 23. On page 5. Now listen carefully and answer questions 21 to 23.
Hi, Marco. Come in.
Thanks.
I've got a bit stuck trying to select courses for next semester. Could you help me, please?
Of course. Sit down. First of all, most people just go for the areas of business that they're interested in. But even if something doesn't look very stimulating, it's important that you can use it once you get a job. It's not much good choosing areas that aren't going to be helpful later on.
Right. I want to go into management, so I'll need to think about that. And should I start specialising in a particular area yet?
I don't think that's wise at this stage. It's better to aim for a wide variety of subjects, especially as management covers so many possibilities. You shouldn't be limiting your choices for later on.
Yes, I see.
You should also look at how the course is made up. Will you have regular seminars and tutorials, for example, as well as lectures?
Okay. Some of the lecturers are quite big names in their fields, aren't they? Mm-hmm. Should I aim to go to their courses?
Well, remember that the lecturers who aren't well known may still be very good teachers. I'd say we have a consistently high standard of teaching in this department, so you don't need to worry about it.
Before you hear the rest of the discussion.
Então vamos lá, gente. Conseguiram pegar quais são as três, os três fatores que ela sugere para o Marco considerar na hora de escolher os cursos? Sim ou não? Então vamos lá, ó. Could you help me, please? Ele pede ajuda. Eu falo, of course, sit down. First of all, most people just go for the areas of business that they are interested in. But even if something doesn't look very stimulating, it's important that you can use it once you get a job. Okay, it's important that you can use it once you get a job. It's not much good choosing areas that aren't going to be helpful later on. E aí, gente? Qual das opções caracteriza o que ela acabou de falar? Relevance to future career. Ela fala que não adianta estudar uma coisa que você só se interessa e que não vai te ajudar quando você conseguir um emprego. Ok? Ela fala ali, even if something doesn't look very stimulating, it's important that you can use it once you get a job. Certo? E aí ele responde, right, I want to go into management, so I'll need to think about that. And should I start specializing in a particular area yet? E ela responde, I don't think that's wise. Então, a gente tem que tomar muito cuidado, porque o exercício pede which three factors does Marco's tutor advise him to consider when selecting a course? E toda vez que ele faz uma pergunta, ele cita uma dessas opções, mas não é o que ele pergunta, e sim o que ela aconselha a ele, ok? Então, fiquem atentos em relação a isso. E ela fala, I don't think that's wise at this stage. It's better to aim for a wide variety of subjects, especially as management covers so many possibilities. Ok? Wide variety of subjects. Onde a gente vê isso? Nas opções ali de A a G. Wide variety of subjects. Range of topics. Ok? Range of topics. Especially as management covers so many possibilities. You shouldn't be limiting your choices for later on. E ele fala, yes, I see. You should also look at how the course is made up. You should also look at how the course is made up. Will you have regular seminars and tutorials, for example, as well as lectures? Ok? Qual dessas opções de A a G que descrevem o que ela está falando? You should also look at how the course is made up. Organization, of course. Okay? Organization, of course. Certo? E aí a gente já achou as três possibilidades, que é a letra B, relevance to future career. É, letra D, organization, of course. E letra F, range of topics. Ok? Certo? Tranquilo? Vocês tinham pego esses três? Vamos para o próximo, então? Ainda com o mesmo áudio, da mesma sessão, a gente vai fazer questões da 24 a 27. Choose the correct letter A, B or C. A gente tem quatro questões. E aí vamos passar junto, antes de tocar o áudio, vamos dar uma olhada junto, o que, que a gente precisa estar atento na hora que a gente estiver, de fato, ouvindo o áudio, ok? Então, 24. Why does Marcos Tutor advise him to avoid the team management course? E aí vocês precisam passar o olho, escanear as opções, ok? It will repeat work intended for students at a lower level. It may make too much time to do well. 25. Why does Marco want to do a dissertation? He thinks it will help his future career. Like to do a detailed study. He has already done some work for it. 26. What does Marco's tutor think about the dissertation outline? Topic is too narrow to be useful. The available data may be unsuitable. The research plan is too complicated. E número 27, what does Marco decide to do about his dissertation? Contact potential interviewees. Change to another topic. Discuss it with Professor Briggs. Ok? Então, vocês precisam passar o olho nas questões antes de começar o áudio. Naquele tempinho que eles dão, vocês vão escanear as questões e as possíveis respostas, certo? Que assim, vocês já ficam com a atenção de vocês ligada no que vocês precisam captar do áudio. E estão em ordem. Tá bom? Então, as questões, nesse caso, estão em ordem, então fica mais fácil organizado. Ok? Então, vamos lá? Vamos ouvir o áudio?
You have some time to look at questions 24 to 30 on pages 5 and 6.
E ela pediu para vocês verem a questão 28 a 30 também. Então, gente, eu vou pausar quando parar, quando ela der a resposta da questão 27. E aí a gente abre a questão 28 a 30 para vocês olharem, darem uma olhada e aí tocar o áudio. Ok? Então, não se preocupem com isso. Então, vamos para 24. E aí é um tempinho maior, porque são mais questões. Mas tudo bem, a gente espera. Sabe que o CD é gravado com essas pausas, tá?
Good. Well, that's a great help.
Now, last time we met, you mentioned doing team management, didn't you?
That's right. I'm still quite keen on the idea.
The trouble is that because of changes in the content of various courses, team management overlaps with the introduction to management course you took in your first year. So what you learned from it would be too little for the amount of time you'd have to spend on it.
I'll drop that idea then. Have you had a chance to look at the outline I wrote for my finance dissertation? I left it in your pigeonhole last week.
Yes. Why exactly do you want to write a dissertation instead of taking the finance modules? It'll be pretty demanding.
Well, I'm quite prepared to do the extra work because I'm keen to investigate something in depth instead of just skating across the surface. I realize that a broader knowledge base may be more useful to my career, but I'm really keen to do this.
Right. Well, I had a quick look through your outline, and the first thing that struck me was that you'll have to be careful how you set about it, as the way you've organized it seems unnecessarily complex. The data that you want to collect and analyze is potentially valuable, but you'll need to narrow down the subject matter to make the whole thing manageable.
Okay. I'll have another look at it. I was talking to Professor Briggs about it yesterday, and I got some more ideas then. For part of the dissertation, I was thinking of trying to persuade finance managers from 3 or 4 companies to let me ask them about their company finances. If not, I think I'll have to change to another topic.
Well, go ahead then. I could give you some names.
Thanks.
Now...
Ok. Então, temos aí as respostas até a 27. Pegaram? Deu para pegar a resposta de cada uma? Então, sobe lá para 24, por favor. Então, 24. Why does Marco's tutor advise him to avoid the team management course? Ela fala, the trouble is that because of changes in the content of various courses, team management overlaps with the introduction to management course you took in your first year. So what you'd learn from it would be too little for the amount of time you'd have to spend on it. Ok, então, letra A. It will repeat work that Marco has already done. Certo? Deu para entender, gente? Ela fala, the trouble is that because of changes in the content of various courses, team management overlaps with the introduction to management course you took in your first year. Ok? Então, it will repeat work that Marco has already done. A 25, why does Marco want to do a dissertation? Né? Ela pergunta bem claramente, ela fala why exactly do you want to write a dissertation instead of taking the finance modules? It will be pretty demanding. E ele responde, well, I'm quite prepared to do the extra work because I'm keen to investigate something in depth instead of just skating across the surface. Okay? I realize a broader knowledge base may be more useful to my career. Okay? Então, resposta, letra B, he would like to do a detailed study. Certo? Ele fala, I'm quite prepared to do the extra work. I'm keen to investigate something in depth. Ok? Número 26. What does Marco's tutor think about the dissertation outline? Ela fala, right, well, I had a quick look through your outline and the first thing that struck me was that you have to be careful how you set about it, as the way you've organized it seems unnecessarily complex. Okay? As the way you've organized it seems unnecessarily complex. Qual das opções que fala isso? The research plan is too complicated. Letra C. The research plan is too complicated. E 27. What does Marco decide to do about his dissertation? E aí? Ele fala, ok, I'll have another look at it. I was talking to Professor Briggs about it yesterday. Ó, cuidado. Uma das opções de resposta é discuss it with Professor Briggs. Mas é a resposta? Não. Ele fala que I was talking to Professor Briggs about it yesterday and I got some more ideas then. For part of the dissertation, I was thinking of trying to persuade finance managers from 3 or 4 companies to let me ask them about their company finances. E aí ele fala uma coisa que também é uma das opções. If not, I think I will have to change to another topic. If not, I think I will have to change to another topic. Então, se não der certo, I think I have to change. Então, não é uma das opções. Qual que é a opção? I was thinking of trying to persuade finance managers from 3 or 4 companies to let me ask them about their company finances. Contact potential interviewees. Ok? Letra A. Contact potential interviewees. Certo? E ela ainda termina falando, I could give you some name. Ok? Agora sim, eu vou colocar na tela para vocês as questões 28, 29 e 30, para a gente terminar de ouvir o áudio. Mas antes, a gente vai dar uma olhada nessas questões, que eles já deram aquele tempinho, para marcar as keywords, ok? Sempre que for exercício para completar a frase, é legal vocês marcarem o que, que tem antes do espaço em branco, antes e depois, tá bom? Mas principalmente o que tem antes do espaço em branco. Atenção ali, write no more than 2 words for each answer. Então, na sua prova você circula ali gigantescamente, que é no more than 2 words, ok? Então, vamos lá. 28, a first draft of the dissertation should be completed by the end of... Gente, o que, que pode ser aí? Quando você vai olhar as questões antes, você tem que se preparar para que tipo de informação tem ali. A first draft of the dissertation should be completed by the end of... Provavelmente um mês. Né? Mas é um tempo ali, um tempo, tá? É um limite ali de tempo, né? By the end of, enfim, deixa ali. Então, coloca, anotem como keyword, só dá uma sublinhada ali para vocês ficarem atentos no áudio. By the end of, ok? A 29, the dissertation should be registered with the... With the, o quê? Of the department. Oh, Jesus. Vamos lá. O que, que tem antes e o que, que tem depois? The dissertation should be registered. Então, já deixa ali circulado, marcado. Of the department. E 30. Marco should get a copy of the statistic software from the... De algum lugar. Certo? Então, a copy of the statistics software. Certo? Vamos ouvir?
Oh, let's talk about practicalities. Your dissertation must be finalized by the end of May. So you should aim to finish the first draft by the end of March. Is that feasible?
Yes, it shouldn't be a problem. I'll need to register for the dissertation, won't I? Is that with the registrar's department?
No, it's internal to this department. So you just need to let the secretary know. Do that as soon as you're sure you're going to write the dissertation.
Okay.
Then to analyze your statistics, you're going to need some suitable software. If I were you, I'd drop into the computer office and ask them for a copy.
Right. So if I revise my...
E aí, pegaram? Vamos lá. A 28 dias, a first draft of the dissertation should be completed by the end of... Gente, nos listenings, né, na prova de listening, acontece demais isso. eles dão duas informações muito parecidas. Então ela fala, now let's talk about practicalities. Your dissertation must be finalized by the end of May. Se você não está atento, você vai lá, pum, marca May. Quem marcou May aí? Não pode, tem que ficar ligado. Porque ela continua, so you should aim to finish the first draft, by the end of March. Tá como começa a questão 28? A first draft of the dissertation should be completed by the end of March. É a resposta correta, tá bom? Então fiquem atentos, não marquem a primeira coisa que você ouvir. Porque é muito comum eles darem uma resposta e falarem, ah, não, não é isso que eu quero tal coisa. Ah, acho que eu mudei de ideia, eu vou querer tal coisa. Ou dá uma informação, fala, não era isso que eu queria dizer. O que eu quero falar, dizer é isso. Tá? Então, fiquem muito atentos no listening. Não se desconectem do áudio em nenhum momento. Não é porque você já encontrou uma resposta e você fala, ah, bom, agora outro deve demorar. Fiquem muito atentos, ok? Continuando, 29. The dissertation should be registered with the of the department. Com quem? Ele pergunta também, né? I'll need to register for the dissertation, won't I? Is that with the registers department? Se você está desatento, o que você coloca? Registered with the registered of the department. Ok? E ela fala, no, it's internal to this department. So you just need to let the secretary know. You just need to let the secretary know. So the dissertation should be registered with the secretary of the department. Okay? Número 30. Marcos should get a copy of the statistics software from the... ela fala, then to analyze your statistics, you're going to need some suitable software. Suitable software. If I were you, I'd drop into the computer office and ask them for a copy. Então, nossa resposta é computer office. Certo? Vamos para a última sessão? Então, vamos lá. É a quarta sessão, questões de 31 a 40. Começa com as questões de 31 a 33. E complete notes. Eu gosto de complete notes. Olha só. Write one word only. Então, na prova de vocês, vão deixar ali gigantesco. One word. Ok? Não pode errar. Certo? Mudando o áudio agora. Olha para essa fichinha que vocês precisam completar de 31 a 33. Começa falando the tiger shark. Quer dizer... É um áudio sobre o Tiger Shark, não há dúvida sobre isso. E aí tem algumas informações. Origin of name, its dark band, size, 6.5 meters, maximum. Preferred habitat, near to the... Isso a gente precisa ouvir, ok? Preferred habitat, near to the... Ok. Typical food, other sea creatures, but also... O que produced by humans? Rain Island area. Studies show tiger sharks are mainly found here during the... Quando? Né? When turtles are nesting. Ok? Vamos ouvir?
Section 4. You will hear a talk about a research project on the tiger shark. First, you have some time to look at questions 31 to 40 on pages 7 and 8.
Mesma coisa, tá? A gente viu de 31 a 33. Aí eu paro o áudio, a gente vai ver as outras questões para depois tocar o áudio, ok? Então fiquem tranquilos. Às vezes eles fazem de 2 a 3 questões, e às vezes eles fazem a sessão inteira. Tipo, olha aí a sessão inteira. A gente vai rodar o áudio direto, tá bom? Mas não se preocupem que aqui a gente vai fazer pausado. Porque as provas não estão impressas na frente de vocês, tá bom? Então a gente tem esse pequeno detalhe. Mas fiquem ligados aí nas palavras que estão perto do espaço para preencher. Que tipo de informação você precisa pegar? Sempre, ok?
Now listen carefully and answer questions 31 to 40.
Good morning, everyone. Today I'm going to talk about the research project I've been involved in on the tiger shark. First of all, some background information. The tiger shark, also known as the leopard shark, is often thought to have got its name from its aggressive nature. But in actual fact, it's called that because it has dark bands similar to those on a tiger's body. It is a huge creature, growing up to lengths of 6.5 meters. It can be found just about everywhere throughout the world's temperate and tropical seas, but it is most often found along the coast rather than the open sea. In terms of feeding, tiger sharks tend to be most active at night and are solitary hunters. Their preferred prey includes other sharks, turtles, seabirds, and dolphins, to name but a few. However, it's not uncommon to find garbage in its stomach. This is because it tends to feed in areas such as harbors and river inlets, where there is a lot of human activity. Now to the project itself. We are particularly interested in some studies that have been done in the Rain Island area. Observations here have shown that there is a large population of tiger sharks present in the summer during the turtle nesting season. However, during the winter months, the sharks disappear. So we decided to do some of our own research there.
Pegaram? Tranquilo, né? Não? Então vamos lá, gente. Vocês percebem que o áudio vai dando as informações na mesma ordem dos exercícios, tá? O que facilita bastante nossa vida, não tá tudo espalhado. Então, vamos lá. Ele fala, good morning, everyone, começa a falar. Onde tá? Aqui, ó. It's a huge creature growing up to length of 6.5 meters. It can be found just about everywhere throughout the world's temperate and tropical seas. But it's most often found along the coast, okay? Rather than the open sea. But it's most often found along the coast. Certo? Rather than the open sea. Então, preferred habitat, near to the coast. Certo? E aí, continuando, typical food, other sea creatures, but also, e ele começa falando, in terms of feeding, tiger sharks tend to be most active at night and are solitary hunters. The preferred prey includes other sharks, turtles, seabirds, and dolphins, to name but a few. However, it's not uncommon to find garbage in its stomach. Garbage. This is because it tends to feed in areas such as harbors and river inlets, where there is a lot of human activity. Okay? 32, other sea creatures, but also garbage produced by humans. Certo? Garbage. E a 33, a Rain Island area, study show tiger sharks are mainly found here during the Ele fala, now to the project itself, we are particularly interested in some studies that had been done in Rain Island area. The Rain Island area, já começa ali com o título da 33. Observations here have shown that there is a large population of tiger sharks present in the summer. Okay? During the turtle nesting. Observations here have shown that there is a large population of tiger sharks present in the summer during the turtle nesting season. However, during the winter months, the sharks disappear. Ok? Então, 31, coast. 32, garbage. 33, summer. Ok? Vamos para o próximo? Para o próximo exercício da mesma sessão, do mesmo áudio. Ok? Eu vou colocar na tela para vocês. Questions 34 to 38. Naquele tempinho ali, que o áudio ficou em silêncio, eu estava falando com vocês, você precisava escanear, olhar todas as questões dessa sessão, de 31 a 40, ok? Então tem esse quadro aí para a gente preencher. E olha lá, o write one word only, certo? Então, pieces of 34 were attached to lines as bait. Isso é como chama isso? Esqueci o nome. Diagrama, né? Que mostra o shark tagging process, ok? Então, pieces of 34 were attached to lines as bait. The lines were, 35, regularly. The hooked shark was brought to the, 36, and secured. The shark was measured and tagged and tissue removed for research. Larger sharks, an acoustic tag was fitted or a, 37, was attached. E the shark was, 38, and could be tracked. Ok, vamos lá, vamos ouvir.
The first step was to tag a number of sharks so that we could follow their movements. To do this, we first needed to catch the sharks. Early in the morning, we baited lines with large bits of fish and set them in place. These lines were then checked.
Desculpa, estou mudando aqui o sistema. Vou parando para vocês perceberem cada resposta que está no áudio, ok? Então, gente, esse primeiro aí, ele fala: the first step was to tag a number of sharks so that we could follow their movements. To do this, we first needed to catch the sharks. Early in the morning, we baited lines with large bits of fish. Ok? É a nossa primeira resposta: fish, and set them in place. E ele continua.
These lines were then checked every 3 or 4 hours.
These lines were then checked. É a nossa segunda resposta. Então, 34, fish, ok? Pieces of fish were attached to lines as bait. 35, the lines were checked regularly. Continuando.
If no sharks were caught, the baits were replaced. Once a shark had been caught on one of the baited hooks, it was pulled in close to the boat and secured. So,
e aí? The hooked shark was brought to the and secured to the boat, right? Tá bem, ele fala assim, ó. Once a shark had been caught on one of the baited hooks, it was pulled in close to the boat and secured. Okay? Close to the boat. Continuando.
We could carry out a number of brief activities to aid our research. This usually took no more than about 10 minutes and was carried out as carefully as possible to minimize any stress to the shark. Each of the tiger sharks that we caught was measured and fitted with an identification tag. and also a small amount of tissue was taken for genetic studies. For some larger sharks over 3 meters long, we also inserted into the belly a special acoustic tag capable of sending satellite signals. While on other large sharks, we attached a camera to the dorsal fin.
E aí? Pegaram? Então ele fala que then, aí tem o próximo quadradinho ali. The shark was measured and tagged and tissue removed for research. Larger shark, over 3 meters. An acoustic tag was fitted or a camera was attached. Camera. Ok? Terminando ali.
To enable us to study the behavior and habitat use of the sharks. After this, the shark was released, and we were able to follow its movements.
After this, the shark was released, and we could be, tracked. Ok, então 38, released. Com 34, fish. 35, checked. 36, bolt, 37, camera, 38, released, ok? E aí tem mais duas questões dessa mesma sessão. Vamos ouvir? Vamos ouvir? Não, vamos ver. São as questions 39 to 40. Choose the correct letter A, B or C. The purpose of the research was to understand the tiger sharks, okay, reproductive patterns, migration patterns, feeding patterns. 40, observations showed that in general, tiger sharks, A, change depths frequently, B, usually avoid the surface of the water, C, often spend long periods on the ocean floor. Vamos ouvir?
So what was the purpose of all this tagging? Well, while we were already familiar with some aspects of the tiger shark's behavior and food sources, what we hoped to do in this project was to see exactly what factors affected the migration patterns of tiger sharks and whether it was, in fact, food, weather, and reproductive needs.
E aí? Migration patterns. Ele fala... Começa assim, né? So what was the purpose of all this tagging? Well, while we were already familiar with some aspects of the tiger shark's behavior and food sources, what we hoped to do in this project was to see exactly what factors affected the migration patterns. Migration patterns. Okay? Continuando.
These are some of our findings. On February 21st, a large female shark, whom we named Natalie, was attracted to our research boat at the northern tip of Rain Island and fitted with one of the satellite tags I've just mentioned. No transmissions were received from Natalie between April 2nd and April 29th, indicating that she didn't surface to feed during this period. The area in which she was last reported is very shallow, suggesting that she may have changed her feeding preferences during this period to focus on prey found on the sea floor. We also made a number of other discoveries, thanks to the various transmitters we used. It seems that tiger sharks move back and forth between the ocean floor and the surface quite often.
Okay. Change depths frequently. O que ele falou? We also made a number of other discoveries thanks to the various transmitters we used. It seems that tiger sharks move back and forth between the ocean floor and the surface quite often. Okay? They move back and forth between the ocean floor and the surface quite often. Então, they change depth frequently. Certo? Tá ótimo. Não, acho que pode ir. Já achamos nossa última resposta. Certo? Gente, o listening É muito importante que no momento, naquele tempo que eles dão para vocês verem as questões, que vocês passem o olho, escaneiem, não dá tempo de ficar lendo, marcando aqui o outro, circulando. Esse tempo a gente tem no reading, que a gente faz o nosso tempo. E não é que é uma coisa lenta, né? Mas é uma coisa que dá tempo de fazer. Aqui, não, você não tem muito tempo, você vê que é rápido, né? É, não é uma coisa controlada humanamente. O CD já é gravado com as pausas. Então, quando o aplicador coloca o CD para rodar, não mexe mais nele. Ele põe para rodar do início ao fim e vai rodar por 30 minutos, mais ou menos. Certo? Então, essas pausas são gravadas. Então, você tem muito pouco tempo só para se familiarizar com as questões. E bater o olho ali o que são keywords, o que vai te ajudar a encontrar a resposta no áudio, ok? Então, ficar muito atento ao número de palavras, as palavras, as keywords que estão antes e depois do espaço em branco para completar. Quando tem várias possibilidades, passar o olho ali para se familiarizar com os nomes, como é o caso daquele mapa, tá bom? Então, no listening, você precisa estar muito ligado. E usar o tempo com inteligência, esse tempo que eles dão antes de começar o áudio, para passar o olho ali, escanear, se familiarizar, para você saber a que tipo de informação você tem que estar atento. Bom, beijos. Thank you very much. E a gente se vê na metodologia Elisato para o IELTS.